And welcome. So in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to put together a complex watercolor composition and the steps you need in order to paint it using layers. This is just a short tutorial, and most of it will probably be set to time-lapse to a bit of music. So first, I want to explain that I've already drawn out my image on my watercolor paper. I'm using Arches cold pressed. I cut my paper to an 8x10, taped it down to, I'm using just a tray, a big plastic like cafeteria tray. It works for me on smaller pieces, so use what you have. And I'm going to start by just doing a wash in the background. So I want to do my background first, and then we're going to work forward. Alrighty. Manganese is a nice light blue, but I want it really watered down back in here. And I'm just tapping in the color because we're going to let this paint do its thing. And I am going to try to move pretty quickly on it. Because we want it to remain wet for just a bit so I can do any lifting that needs to be done. I do want to kind of maybe put a few little indications of clouds up in here. And we don't have to, because we've already got our lines drawn in there, we don't have to be that precise. Kind of just do a nice little wash coming through here. Now I've got my paper laying flat. A lot of times for these washes, I like to put it at an angle on an easel, but my easel is full right now because I am working on a oil painting that is in the process of drying. I was going to paint on it some today, but this morning my layer of oil was still not dry enough to where I feel comfortable working on it. So I said, well, I'm going to do a watercolor. So while it's still wet, I want to make sure I get my edges up there. I want to come in with some clean tissue and just do it. I don't want them to look all the same, so. And that ought to give us a little indication of some clouds just coming in up there. There we go. Oh, I like that. Make a little bit darker. I don't want to touch it too much on this first layer. But I do want to come in just a bit. And if I get some on the bar or out of line, that's fine. We're not coloring in. I mean, there's nothing wrong with coloring in, but we do want it to kind of come through in some places. But I don't want to overtouch it, because once you start touching something that's drying, it will muck it up. So I'm going to let that part dry and come down here and work a little bit on this grass. Don't want to work on this part yet, but I just want to block in some color. we'll come back and do the details after this dries. So for the grass, yeah, I'm gonna start with a green gold. Okay, so that dried for a few minutes, but then I did go in with a bit more back here in the background with some blue and a little bit, I dropped in a little bit of this green. We want that to dry very faint, and it will. So it's still drying a bit, but I think we're going to come here and work a bit on our, yeah, let's work on our cabin back here. Cabin / barn. There are several ways you can gray something down. You can use like a neutral tint from Daniel Smith has a really good neutral tint. I actually did a video review on that. I can link that down below. But you can use Payne's Gray, which is a little bit more on the cooler side, or a lot of times what I'll do is just use the complementary color on the color wheel to gray your stuff down. So if your sky is blue and you don't want it a blue, it's a gray day, you're going to put in a bit of orange and that will neutralize it. So knowing a little bit of color theory, which I actually love color theory, can really help improve your art. So, I'm going to let that dry for just about 5-10 minutes. So that is dry, and I thought I would go ahead and grab me a little bit of this Moon Glow. It's got more of a like a purple undertone to it. Wonderful for shadows. I'm coming in with some more of this trans yellow. I'm going to come in with more of this Payne's Gray. Up under, I'm gonna go ahead and lay in my let's lay in our bushes back here. Let's go ahead and work on the shadow here, and for that, I think I want to use the Moon Glow for that. I'm liking this Moon Glow. I'm liking that shadow so far. Alright. I want to make my truck. I want to do just a little bit more detail on this cabin. Just a little bit. I'm going to switch to a smaller brush. I'm going to go into my burnt umber. main focus to be on the strut, really. So my most contrasting values need to be here. So my lightest of lights and my darkest of darks need to be in this truck. It's the focal point. So I'm gonna leave the cabin as is right now. I say that and now I see where I need a little bit of shadows down in here, but red wine. I think red wine would be a good color for my I almost feel like I want to start with the shadow areas. I don't know why, but and that's what I'm gonna do. So the light's going to be hitting this truck a bit from that area. So I think I can go ahead and add in my red. I want to start with the carmine. And this is a wine red. In that. Okay, let's work on the little bit of the grass over here. Work on my tree a little bit because that's drying. I've got my sap green right here. And the thing I like to do is vary the greens for sure. Always mixing them. I don't want to use just one flat color. We want to vary it. We want to come in and drop in just little places of little bit more while it's wet, because that's going to give us a really nice effect of wet and wet. I'm going to add some of that sap green. Brush and coming in with more of this grass up in here, because I decided my shadow was not dark enough. Kind of got some blooms in there, which is really cool. I think it works. We will come underneath. I'm gonna go ahead and do the trunk of this tree. I'm gonna start again with my So what do we have left to do? I think what I'm going to do is actually come in with my shadows in here, and then more shadows on the tree, and then I'm going to let it completely dry before I go in with some darker darks. Ooh. I've let that layer dry, and now I'm going to come in with a little bit more saturation here on my road, on my truck. And then remember, I want my darkest darks and my lightest lights. Here are my focal points. Now, I think I'm going to put some finishing touches on it. come in here with a bit more saturated grass. I still need some pretty heavy highlight there. There we go. I'm just gonna stop fussing with it now. I'm done. I'm calling it done. I would like to thank you for watching today, and please be sure to subscribe, check out my social media, and I will see you for the next painting. Thank you.